It's so interesting as well how many ingredients had to come together for this Puskás nomination.
That's the one thing about Ireland, is that everyone knows everyone over here.
Been one of them where you're like, that was class, and you go out in the back garden and try and do it.
It's a fairy tale. A children's book should be written about that story.
10 years ago this week, Stephanie Roche changed the course of Irish women's football history, but how did she do it? To find out how, Deb Shaw has joined alongside me here today. Are you all excited?
I am very excited. I can't wait to see this goal that you can't stop talking about, honestly.
I wonder, is it like, would you say it's contained within an Irish bubble that people kind of know about this?
100%. I think it's like a Irish pop culture moment. And like, I've been here for a while, but I haven't been here that long. So yeah, no, I'm excited to see it. And I'm excited to find out like what Ireland was back then, what the women's sports scene was back then. So yeah.
We'll have to get you in on reeling in the ears there, Deb. Yes. 10 years ago today, or this week anyways, like we were talking about, 20th of October 2013, Stephanie Roche scored a goal for Peamount United, but little did she know how important that would turn out to be. It was against Wexford Utes in the Women's National League. Let's have a look at it here now. So, Deb, this is the famous goal, the little flick over the shoulder and bang into the top corner.
That's crazy. No, that's so good. I know that it's going to loop again, but like I just want to see it over and over. Like it's such a... What?
Yeah. You definitely aren't the only one that wanted to see that, because even the technique of it, like the ability to be able to do that. I also think it's quite funny how they're all so excited. Like, I know it was an unbelievable goal, but they're all like, yeah, they know even in that moment that was spectacular.
It's also one of those videos that the more you watch it, you keep looking at a different person in the video and there's a different reaction. So like the defender is just moving from side to side. Like, look at the control on that. One, two, three. Defeat.
And then you say each time you pick out a different person, you can see there over to the side of the screen, do you recognize her? Eileen Gleeson.
I see a ginger.
Eileen Gleeson, interim manager of the Irish women's national team at this current moment. It shows you how long she's been around the game.
It's crazy. Like, I knew that the moment that she was like assigned like head of women's like football and whatnot, I read up a little bit on her and I saw that she has been around for a while. But like to see her there ingrained like in history still is unreal to see. And like, look at that. Look at that. Just, she's so happy for her.
Ingrained in history is exactly the right way to look at it, especially when you see how grainy the footage is. I know it was only 2013, but it's amazing to see how far things have come, because even when we were chatting about it before, like to score this amazing goal, but second of all, to have it on video, because women's football at the time wasn't really in that kind of landscape. You know, people weren't watching these games on streams or whichever. That's only came in the last number of years. So to even have it on video at all is testament, I suppose, to Eileen Gleeson. And you would imagine that this was obviously someone around her or around the team that was capturing these videos.
Yeah. And also that's what just made me think over there is that I wonder, and it probably is the reason why that we even have this footage, is most likely she was recording that match for match footage to show the players in training sessions in order to improve the game. Think about like 2013 Ireland, and you have Eileen Gleeson over there with like a grainy camera recording match footage. Like, just shows how ahead of her years she is. Either that or she just wanted to record the film, you know. This is my assumption that like... But I do think it is most like... Oh, sorry. That goal is so good.
Do you reckon we'll see a Stephanie Roche, David Beckham style doc in the coming years? We'll have to wait and see. But again, the other thing about this goal is like, there was probably only 100 people at this match. You know, women's football wasn't getting the support it is now. And this is probably the moment that kickstarted it all. Even the men's team were really getting behind this, and everybody was pushing it all over Ireland. It was one of those moments that transcended... not only women's sport, but transcended sport. Like, everybody was like, I get behind this girl. You know, we're going to vote for her, even though you might not even know what the Puskás nominations were.
Fully. And it's interesting as well, because it's like one of those things where the moment that you see something like that happen to someone you most likely know or connected to, that's the one thing about Ireland, is that everyone knows everyone over here. So I think it's quite cool to see just like the support that she had behind her when that happened.
it's so interesting as well how many ingredients had to come together for this Puskás nominated goal to come together that ultimately changed not only Stephanie's life, but like the perception of women's football in this country. And I would imagine worldwide. I know we were chatting about the start that maybe it didn't transcend over a 10-year period kind of way. Maybe that's a memory kind of looking back kind of thing more than anything. But especially when you consider like women's football was in its infancy here in Ireland when that kind of kicked off. Obviously, we had leagues before that, but the Women's National League had only entered maybe 2 years beforehand. That was in 2011. And like to think that this was only 2 years after that, it was amazing to see all the players that have come out of this and even were then getting the attention that they deserve.
Would you know the year that this photo was in?
So this was actually at the Women's National League launch in 2011, which is 2 years before the goal actually happened. But even here, you can spot a few characters you might know, I'd say.
Look at Louise Quinn Brunette.
Exactly. There's a few there, people I know. So give us your answers in the comments if you spot anybody you recognise. But yeah, this just tells you where women's football was at. Like, we had the matches before and obviously teams were playing each other, but this brought it into a structured fashion. So that just tells you what a moment this was in women's football that brought it on to another level altogether. Now, obviously, out of all this, Stephanie made it to the 2014 Puskás Award Ceremony, the FIFA Ballon d'Or ceremony as well. This is her arriving there. Like, isn't this just unbelievable?
It's literally a young girl's dream. Not every young girl's dream, but that's what they always imagined. And, like, if I were to put myself in her shoes, right, to think that just playing against Wexford youths in your like local league at the time and then ending up in an outfit like this on the red carpet sounds like a dream. That's the only word that I like can think of right now. It's crazy.
Especially Deb, like considering I'm all for the Women's National League. Yeah. Anybody that knows, like, yeah, I literally watched that hardcore, but like it was Peamount United, Wexford Utes, the goal that she scored, that was the match it was in. But she was up against James Rodríguez and Robin van Persie, who scored their goals at the 2014 World Cup. Unbelievable.
You know what I'm imagining, though, being in there and just seeing, like, the reels of these highlights and, like, what goals were nominated and just the high-quality videos of, like, Robin van Persie and whatnot. And then just, like, oh, and look at this grainy one-angled footage from 100 meters behind. But look, the ball got into the goal and thank God that was filmed. Honestly, it's a fairy tale. Like, a children's book should be written about that story.
Unbelievable. Because then even obviously at the award ceremony, there was all the chat about how she was one of the first women to be nominated. She was actually the sixth woman ever to be nominated for it, but definitely the first person from Ireland to be at the Ballon d'Or ceremony anyways. So unbelievable. And as we said, up against James Rodríguez and Robin van Persie. So there was 3.3 million votes cast overall. Do you have any idea what percentage? Obviously, James Rodríguez won. That's no surprise. In the end, like, Stephanie's goal was unbelievable. But, you know, ultimately, given the time period and everything we're in. But do you have any idea what the percentage breakdown would have been?
Like, if I were to put myself, I don't know, maybe like 800K.
Okay, so out of the 3.3 million, Rodríguez got 42%, Van Persie 25%. And Stephanie Roche got 33%. So she actually bet Robin van Persie, you know, that famous diving header?
Header, yeah.
Yeah, you know it. But yeah, she bet that.
Crazy.
Again, just testament to how much people got behind it at the time. Because it's so funny as well, thinking back at it now, like a woman to be at that stage in women's football was such a novelty that people were nearly watching it going, it was an unbelievable goal. And then, oh my God, it was a woman that scored it as well. Like, which is crazy even thinking now, because we're at, I'd say it shows you how far women's football has come, because the perception has slowly changed and now we're kind of at a time where it's like we see these goals all the time.
Mm-hmm. We do see these goals all the time. What I find interesting as well is that, like, the acknowledgement that her goal in that league was also up there nominated in the top three. Like, I would have assumed that, like, oh, it doesn't count. We're talking about, like, I don't even know if the WSL was going on at the time, but like certain leagues needed to be like qualified, you know what I mean? But yeah, no, it's crazy. And also the amount of goals that are being scored right now, like before football was, I do think that the game has developed and there are certain things that people miss. There are certain things that people prefer now. But overall, what I would say is that football at that time, you rarely got those type of goals. You know what I mean? So it was like extra special.
And if you did, they certainly weren't captured for the world to see. Like this was a viral moment of global scale. But it was one that saw her rub shoulders as well with Messi and Ronaldo. Look, she's fitting right in there.
Oh, stop.
Unbelievable. And she really, you know, she deserves her plaudits there, because while all those things came together, she still had to score it. And what the most, I suppose, inspirational thing I think about this story is Stephanie really took the time to promote women's football with this. You know, she could have just went, oh, you know, like this was the goal, da da da. But she took it as much more than that, even at the time, to the point where this still gets talked about today. Like, this is unbelievable.
No, that's literally insane. I really hope that she has that framed and hung up on her wall. Now, I'm wondering here, is that Abby Wambach in the back as well with the white shirt? I do think it is.
You could spot a few stars there.
You can spot a few stars. So it's not just them two, right? But it's crazy to just like pause. Oh, sorry, Messi. Sorry, Ronaldo. Let me just like scooch over here. Crazy. Unreal.
Well, look, she made them stand up and take notice, or sit down and take notice. She was the one standing up.
Yeah, the queen's here.
And then even what's most interesting as well is her reaction afterwards. She was quite disappointed not to have won. That shows you again just how much people were getting behind this. We'll take a look at that.
Stephanie, reaction, first of all. I suppose slight disappointment, obviously being a footballer. I would have
got it.
Won the award, but
oh my God.
Right now it's my chance to just thank everybody.
Fair play to her. You know, I feel like there's a pressure on women to feel grateful and like, thank you, happy to be here, you know, like, what can you do? And just to go out and be like, I'm gutted. I wanted to win it.
Yeah, I mean, obviously.
Go on, Stephanie.
Being an Irish person, being the first Irish person to get here and also being the first female has been fantastic for me. And as you say, Colombia is an awful lot bigger than Ireland. So I think that we were that close. Means a lot to me, so it's again.
I think she's slightly doing herself a disservice there. Like, I know she's saying that it was just Irish people that got behind her, but I think it was people all over the world being like, go on, girl, like you were saying.
Yeah, it's been a crazy, crazy ride, I suppose. I've done so much stuff that I probably wouldn't have done.
Thierry Henry.
Yep.
It's not even when Stephanie met Thierry, it's when Thierry met Stephanie.
Yeah.
Let's be honest.
The feedback from,
love that.
From people such as pro footballers and ex-pros, but I think it's the people who mean more to me would be the people who know me best and are happy for me. So,
oh, that's amazing.
What happens from here now, Stephanie? Because that's the question people at home are going to wonder. Where do you go? What do you do from here?
I don't know, I suppose. Obviously, I have been building up to this for a long time, and now that it's kind of over, I suppose we're going to
makes you wonder though, like players, like I know that it's just like the times and it's out of people's control, but sometimes you wonder like, oh, I wish we had X player now, you know, like she missed that boat out of just age, you know what I mean? Just like with the bandwagon happening right now.
I think it's so such a point to hone in on as well. You know, they're showing the glitz and glam there of the red carpet and the male footballers. But like Stephanie Roche at this time was playing for a French league side and she was making £650 a month plus living expenses. They were making that probably in the walk up to the podium for the award. Yeah. Now, that might be a bit of exaggeration, but you get my point. Yeah, they were making astronomical money.
Already.
And yeah, women's football was, I suppose, still on the up, as it still is now. But she mentioned what she was going to do after that. She went on to play in 4 of the 5 highest rated leagues in women's football at the time. So I touched on the French league there. She played for Houston Dash, obviously, in the NWSL. Played for Sunderland and Fiorentina before returning to the Women's National League in 2010. And then, obviously, her Ireland career as well is not one to be forgotten. So she's 58 caps for Ireland. Can you pick her in the lineup there, Deb?
Number 12.
Way!
In fairness, I was looking for a fringe and then I'm like, no, I need a headband there. So yeah, number 12.
Yeah, so after that, she did, of course, go on to play 58, obviously, games for Ireland. Now, she did fall out of favour for a bit, but she did play last year, which is where this photo was taken. So she played against the Philippines in Turkey when they were preparing for the World Cup. So still going, still competing definitely at the highest level. Now, instead of Peamount United, controversially, some would say, back with Shamrock Rovers, who obviously are the newly formed team in the Women's Premier Division. So still scoring goals there, of course, as well. But yeah, it's just unbelievable that obviously that was 2013. Now it's 2023 on a different kind of career spectrum. But yeah, she's played in four of the five top leagues in the world.
She's still going. She is still going. And fair play to her. I wonder, like, I'm assuming she just probably wanted to settle here, you know, with Amy and all that kind of stuff. But I find it very impressive when women figured it out in that time, if that makes sense. Like, the likes of women like her didn't have any other women most likely to look up to. If they did have, it would have been a few. So to think that, like, she figured it out. She played in four of the top five leagues worldwide. That's crazy. And like, God knows the pot that she set for other Irish girls to look up to that are now in that team that we just saw.
Yeah, and I think it's important to say as well, one thing that I'd like to emphasize is that obviously Stephanie's goal was unbelievable, but it is that culmination of luck in one way where it was all captured. Now, the goal was unbelievable, and I'm not anything against her skills or everything, legend of the game, but how many other fantastic goals in the Women's National League didn't we get to see because women's football wasn't on that platform?
100%. And also, I think if you were to just describe that goal right there, no way, if you were to just, like, I can imagine it. Someone just goes, oh, so she lobbed her pass and then juggle, and then just, like, shoot into the top bins. Come on. That was outside the box, I think, as well. Everyone would say you're having a laugh. Everyone would say that. So, like, good for cameras. Good stuff. Good stuff,
it's
Eileen.
So funny. It's where it's like the 1980s or the 1950s even we're talking about with the camera quality and everything. But yeah, brilliant to see. And it definitely gave her notoriety in Ireland. You know, she went on, obviously, as I said, she played for Ireland, but she's also a public figure now, you know. And she's also a commentator. I'm sure you hear her when you listen to the Ireland matches sometimes. And yes, I think it's important how much she put back into the women's game. You know, she could have taken that for herself, and she chose to, you know, promote everybody else as well as herself, and not just like her own team, but the league and women's football as a whole. So I think what she did was definitely unbelievable. The impact it had was unprecedented. And even at the time, you know, we didn't have as many female role models in sport as we do now. Like, Katie Taylor was obviously on the rise probably around the time this video was taken. You know, the 2012 Olympics was her big kind of marking point. And then you would have had, so Katie Taylor, Sonia O'Sullivan, maybe Dervla O'Rourke. Okay. And then at this time it was Stephanie Roche. And, you know, it's just so amazing that I can name them on one hand.
Yeah.
And now I couldn't have enough to do it.
Were you playing football at the time? Soccer?
Yeah, I would have been, yeah.
What would have the conversation been like at the time for your team and whatnot when the goal went viral?
I mean, it just would have been one of them where you're like, that was class. And then you go out in the back garden and try and do it.
Did you manage to do it?
And then your coaches be raging because they're like, what are you doing that for?
And then, like, you try and do it against, like, a team. And
you'd be like, what? Stephanie Roche did it. She's promoting the women's game.
Exactly. No, it's just one of those things where if you attempt it and you fail it, you are 100% running sprints the next day.
Yeah, but like, she didn't. She scored it. And as you say, put women's football on the map in Ireland, some would say. So yeah, that's the goal. Anyways, what's your final thoughts?
First of all, I'm speechless because that goal is still, like, it's absolutely insane. I love to see Eileen Gleeson over there. I think it's just one of those things where like, I heard about Eileen. I knew that she has been around the block and she's been around for a while and she knows women's football in Ireland like the back of her hand. But to see her there and present and so happy. And it kind of, like, I feel like she also hasn't changed. Like, watching her, like, coach the Irish team now, like, she still seems as enthusiastic and as, like, in love with the sport, which I am obsessed with. But yeah, I think that's basically it. I think it's quite cool to see just, like, a fairy tale happen. And she made it happen. And in fairness, also, fair dues to the people that also pushed her in regards to, like, no, this should be nominated. No, like, it's also a community thing. Like, let's get behind her. It's not one of those things of, like, oh, that Irish woman just got nominated. Like, okay, like, let's sweep it to the side, sort of. Like, no, amazing stuff. Well done. Well done to everyone involved. Not just, like, Stephanie, although, like, she has a lot to say about it.
I think that's been my favourite bit about actually looking over this topic, is even looking at the Women's National League photos there, or trying to, if you can, pick out anybody in that video. Like, there's so many names within Irish football right now. Let's say Rebecca Cree, Rihanna Jarrett, Louise Quinn. You know, if you go through those, you'll see Karen Duggan, I'm sure, Pearl Slattery. These are people who basically like built women's football in this country. Sue Ronan was the Irish manager at the time. She's in quite a number of the Women's National League launch photos. Like, it's just so interesting how it's paying off now.
Yes.
You know, at the time it's a struggle and it's picking away, keep going, let's see what happens. And I'm sure that's why the World Cup was such a payoff for the likes of these people, because they put so much into it. It's just great to see them getting stuff out of it. Yeah.
And it's also just one of those things where, like, they've been around, these women have been around, like, with the fame that's happening now and whatnot, everyone probably thinks like, oh, you know, Katie McCabe just started playing for Arsenal. Like, no, she hasn't. Like, she was playing here. These players have been present and they've been just grinding it out. And now a good few of them are like kind of enjoying the fruits of their labor, sort of.
For sure. And you know what, Deb, you can catch this most weeks now on the League of Ireland TV, the Women's Premier Division, so you can spot the next Stephanie Roche, I'm sure. Only a few weeks left there. But for now, thanks for joining us here today.
Thank you. I had fun. And this was a really good chat. And anyone else, if you have any suggestions, if you want us to react to any women's sports videos, let us know in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe and like it and all that sort of stuff. If you want to read more, find out more, our website is www.hersport.ie, and follow us on other social media platforms. We're nearly at 70k on Instagram, so see us there. Bye bye.